Toutes et tous, j'espère que vous allez très bien aujourd'hui. Le voilà, nous allons parler des pronoms i et on aujourd'hui. So today we're going to talk about the pronouns i and on, which are not intuitive but are actually quite simple. So I suppose if you're going to be unintuitive, that being simple is a good thing. So we're going to start with on, the en. To replace or to be able to say some of it in French. Okay, you know how to say some in French. You use des or du or de la or de l'apostrophe. So, j'ai des stylos, I have pens. Il a besoin d'argent, he has need of money. Nous achetons du gâteau, we buy some cake. And when I mean some cake, I mean, let's say you go to a cafe. And you want to get some cake with your coffee, you would say, je voudrais du gâteau. I will want some cake. You might say a piece of cake as well, but either way, they can both work. This isn't just like saying some random cake. How do you replace the noun when it has de in some form in front of it to say some of it? Or how do you say one of them or 10 of them? Well, you use on. And one places on before the verb. So at the end of this presentation, I'm going to give you the chart again that you've already seen, where you have the different pronouns and their order. And but for the moment, just know that it's going to go in front of the verb, which is where you put all of those pronouns that are replacing something. So here are some examples. Je veux du café. I want some coffee. So we're going to replace du café, some coffee, with on and put it in front of the verb. So we made it real easy. We just have one verb there. J'en veux. So this does say I want some coffee. This is your grumpy self. I'm getting up in the morning. I want coffee. Everybody back off. And maybe you have someone super nice in your life who's going to make you some. Tu veux du café? Oui, j'en veux. Yes, I would like some. J'en veux. Elle veut de la viande. She would like some meat. And it sounds really nice in French. I don't know. It sounds rather cavemanish in English for some reason to me. But it sounds, and which is fine. I'm just saying it sounds a little bit different or quite different in French. When you would say something like "Elle veut de la viande," it's I'm thinking you're out shopping and this, and you're going to be using something for a main course, in any event. Elle veut de la viande. You're going to drop off de la viande and replace it with on. Elle en veut. She wants some of it. Vous buvez de l'eau. You drink some water. Vous en buvez. You hear the z there. Vous en buvez. Vous en buvez. And that's just because the s is bumping up against that vowel. Ils ont des stylos. They have some pens. Ils en ont. That's so hard to say, I know. Ils en ont. Because you have several things going. You have a liaison, which is the S to the E, and you have an enchaînement, which is the N to the O. So, ils ont and en ont. So, ils en ont. And practice that one, huh? Tu as un stylo. So, this is you have a pen, but it also means you have one pen, because un is the number one. Tu as un stylo is tu en as un. Tu en as un. It's not an easy thing to say, so just slow down. Tu en as un. Tu en as un. Nous avons trois voitures. You will notice, by the way, with the un that it does stay there. Unlike the deux and all of its forms, which goes away. The un stays there. That is the same thing with nous avons trois voitures. It becomes nous en avons trois. We have three of them. So you still keep. We keep the number because otherwise nous en avons means we have some. And in this case, nous en avons trois. We have some of, or we have three of them. So it's important to keep the trois or the number there. So, Again, each time you need to form, you need a form of de or un, une or a number in order to say some and then replace it with all. Okay. Again, let me just go back here and just say we've got the any form of de, du, de la, de l' apostrophe, and then we have a number that includes un, une, even though that can also mean a or an. And all of those things are going to be replaced with on. Okay, you place the on before the verb. The E drops off with je, ne. Anytime you're encountering, anytime you have those two vowels together, you have to drop it off. The E drops off. So it's not je en veux, it's j'en veux. The number stays, whereas the de goes. We did just talk about that. So you would say, je veux du café, j'en veux. The du and the noun disappear. Whereas, je veux trois voitures, j'en veux trois. The number remains. All right? Simple as that. And again, when you get into it and start to practice, it's going to give you a little bit of a challenge, but that's okay. Using the pronoun i. Okay, first of all, note that E sounds like an I, the letter I in French. So it has the same sound and it also is treated like a vowel. So if there's an S that precedes it, you're going to have the Z sound to make that liaison. You've learned that you replace an indirect object, that's a person or an animal, with lui and leur. And of course, me, te, nous, and vous as well. But those two, lui and leur, are our new ones. To replace a non-human or non-animal that's part of a prepositional phrase with an a, in other words, a and the noun, you use i. Okay, it's really simple. If it's a and a noun that's not human or animal, then it's going to be replaced with i. So, exemple. Est-ce que vous vous intéressez à l'art moderne? Notice that it's vous vous intéressez. This is a reflexive, so it's vous vous intéressez. And it also has a Z popping up against the I. Okay, so we have à l'art moderne. So we have à and we have our noun. And by the way, the adjective is associated with that noun. So all of that is going to be replaced because you're not going to say, are you interested in modern art? And you come back and say, I'm interested in it modern. So you're just going to replace everything, everything that's there. Oui, nous nous y intéressons. Yes, we are interested in it. Okay? Ah is one of the, it's just a preposition. It's going to be replacing all sorts of things. It's an idiomatic expression. And so sometimes you just have to, you have to memorize sometimes the verb, which is, for instance, intéresser à is to interest, is to be interested in something. So, okay, so participons-nous au tournoi? Are we participating in the tournament? And the answer is non, vous n'y participez pas. So participe, maybe you're asking your coach, participons-nous au tournoi? And the coach says, no, you are not. Non, vous n'y participez pas. Okay, so again, that E goes in front of the verb, and it's worth noting that the N apostrophe or the N-E, the E drops off because again, the Y is treated like a vowel. Penses-tu au sport? Do you think about sports? Non, je n'y pense jamais. No, I never think about it. Okay? So it's as simple as that when you're replacing an a and a noun, and now we're going to replace a place. It does replace, the pronoun e also replaces a place. It's the, kind of the same thing, but it's a little bit broader because you don't always have a and a place. Sometimes you might have en and a place, or you might have even de if it's a place. You're returning from a place, okay? But just remember, if you have a place and you want to replace it, you're going to use en or e. So, for instance, vas-tu en Italie? Oui, j'y vais. Yes, I'm going there. So, in this sense, it means there, because you're replacing a place. Pourquoi nous allons à l'aéroport? Nous y allons pour chercher ta mère. We're going there in order to look for your mother. Remember, it's always chercher is look for. You never use pour with chercher. Comment va-t-on en Malte? Malte is Malta. And remember, if you're going to a country, the country is either masculine or feminine. And so it's either going to be on or it's going to be au. Or, it just depends on if the country is masculine or feminine or starts with a vowel. On y va en bateau. We're going by boat. Here is your pronoun order. It doesn't matter if the me, te, nous, vous are direct and indirect, just to be repetitive about that. They always go first, and then le, la, les, and then lui, leur, and then finally i and on. So on is always going to be the last. And if you're wondering, do you often see that? Yes, you do. So il y a, the expression il y a is there is or there are, and il y en a. Okay, il y en a is going to be something quite common because there are some. All right. Si vous avez des questions, laissez-moi savoir et je vous souhaite une très bonne journée. Au revoir.